Welcome back to Replay Mondays. This week's Replay Monday video is headgear. You can find the verses and notes for it right here. Let's get ready to watch an amazing word from the Lord. Grab your coffee, grab something to write on, and let's watch Replay Mondays.
We serve a strong God. You better take that stance today. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. And we're going to walk in fact over fiction. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. We serve a strong God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. We serve a strong God. We serve a you don't serve no weak God. Remember, I think I preached that not too long ago. You do not serve a weak God. You don't serve, you serve the same God. You serve the same God that you've been serving. You serve the same God. He is God and he sits on the throne. You say a strong God, a strong God, a strong God, a strong God, a strong God. You serve a same strong God. We thank you, Lord God. You serve a strong God. My God, a strong God. I just keep hearing that in my spirit. We serve a strong God. He is a strong God. And when we rest in his strength and when we say he's a strong God, we're just affirming what we believe about him. We say, I hear that. I hear the rumbling, my God. I hear the rumbling rising up. I hear the rumbling rising up. We serve a strong God. Can you just say that? We serve a strong God, and we do not have to be strong. Our strength is in God. So where you are weak, you don't care. But Lord, I don't care how weak I am. I'm strong in you. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. Daddy God, we serve a strong. You are mighty. You are the mighty. You are mighty. You are mighty in battle. You serve a strong God. You serve a strong God. Lord God, I thank you for being a strong God. I thank you for being a faithful God. I thank you for being a just God. I thank you, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God. We serve a strong God. So today, I want to get into the word. Yeah, we serve it. That's deep in my spirit. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. Vanessa, we declare that fever break right now in Jesus' name. We declare that your body is normal and every cell and every tissue and every fiber in your body aligns with the word of God. You've been serving our country faithfully. You serve a strong God. Your God is stronger than any fever that you can have. So we declare that fever is broken in your body right now in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord. Lay hands on yourself and command the fever to break. Command every tissue, every cell, and every fiber in your body to line up with the word of God. And we stand in faith with you, woman of God, and we stand in agreement with you that your body is performing according to what the word of God says. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong. That is our war cry today. That is our war cry. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. If you're going to post anything, post that today. Hashtag tag each other in it. We serve a strong God. Tell them I was on Coffee and Conversations today, and I was reminded we serve a strong God, a God who is mighty in battle. We serve a strong God in Jesus' name. And our strength comes in our salvation. And that's what you can take a hold of. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong. You better let the devil know we serve a strong God. You better let any plague, any virus, anything coming against you. No, we serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. He ain't no weak God. He a strong God. And God is moving for us. And God loves us. And God protects us. We serve a strong God. We serve us. And that's where I'm finding my strength. We serve a strong God. A God that's mighty in battle. Yeah, a God that's mighty in battle. We serve a strong God. Our God is mighty in battle. We serve a strong God, right? We serve a strong God. So turn around and let salvation, the Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Your God has commanded your strength. Show yourself strong. My God, we serve a strong God. That's Psalms 24:8. Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Be lifted up, O ancient doors, the King of glory may enter. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O you gates, be lifted up. We serve a strong God. We serve a strong God. So I just want to give you this about the helmet of salvation today, and we're going to get off here today. I hope you feel encouraged. I hope you feel encouraged. I hope you feel encouraged today, because we serve a strong God. Our God ain't no weak God. Our God ain't no weak. We ain't got no weak God. We ain't got no God that can only be dealt with when we put an idol up. We got a living and active God that will move heaven and hell. He said, if you go to the depths of hell, if you go to the grave, I'm still with you. We serve a strong God. So today we're going to put on our helmet of salvation. He does know. We just got to know, Xavier. He does know. He's not going to ever quit. So we have to take the position that we serve a strong God. The devil is not going to quit. The devil is always going to come up with some scheme, some tactic. He's not wanting heaven to win. He knows his time is about up. So you got to know you are strong. He's strong, a strong God. He's strong God, right? He's a strong God, right? Yes, he serves a strong God. That's what we got to say to ourselves. Psalms 24:8. This is the Lord who is strong, mighty in battle. This is the same love. If God is for us, who can be against us? So let's put on our helmet of salvation today. Can you put on your helmet of salvation today? Right? This is your cap. This is your helmet of salvation. This is your head gear, right? And so we're putting on our helmet of salvation today, not hoping that we are saved, knowing that we are saved, that we are already saved. And it is the assurance in our helmet of salvation that God will triumph, right? That God will triumph. It is our assurance, our hope in our salvation that God will triumph. So today we're putting on our salvation, our helmet of salvation that comes through Christ Jesus, that says no matter what, God is going to triumph. 1 Thessalonians 5:8 says, but let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for an helmet, the hope of salvation. There is hope in your salvation today. One of Satan's most effective weapons against us is discouragement. When we are properly equipped with the helmet of salvation, it is hard for us to be discouraged. Satan wants you to be discouraged. And so when we operate with the helmet of salvation on, we remember that we will triumph over the enemy. We remember that with salvation, we were bought with a price. We remember with salvation that Jesus already took on every sickness, every disease, every sin that we've had, and we rest in our salvation. Salvation is when Jesus comes in our lives and takes away our sins. And what he's doing is he's saving us from the eternity of hell. It is not something you can earn. It is a gift that is given to you. And so because God is so holy and he can't be in the presence of sin, all we do first, right? All we do first is we're going to make sure that we are firm in our salvation, right? We're firm. We accept that we are sinners. We believe Jesus Christ died for our sins. We confess our sins to him. And then we get to experience eternity with God. So God chose to save us through our Lord Jesus Christ, not to pour out his anger on you. So when people start telling you, well, the coronavirus is God's wrath upon us, you got to begin to ask yourself, does this make sense? You got to begin to ask yourself, does this make sense? We need to be. That's why 1 Thessalonians 5:8-9 says, let us who live in the light be clear headed, protected by the armor of faith and love, and wearing as our helmet the confidence of our salvation. He already gave the audible. He already saved us through Jesus Christ, right? So when Satan tries to convince us that God will no longer love us, you need to say, and that we are no longer saved, you need to say, no, I am saved. I have on the helmet of salvation. You need to remember what Romans Let me go there. What Romans 8:37-9 says, right? When he's trying to tell you, oh, you're about to die. Well, if he starts talking death to you, you need to start telling him, but I live in Jesus Christ. But I live in Jesus Christ. When he starts talking death to you and trying to consume you with your death, you need to start saying to him, but I live in Jesus. I live in Jesus Christ. This temple right here is only temporary. This temple right here is only temporary. So if when the enemy starts trying to talk to you about that, you need to say, well, I live in Jesus Christ. I don't live in this body. I'm a spiritual being. I'm only here on assignment. I live in Jesus Christ. Romans 8:37 says, no, despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loves us. And I'm convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor demons, neither our fears for today, nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below. Indeed, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. And so when we get confident in that the helmet of salvation is on and that it doesn't matter, Satan looks, it looks different. It all begins to look different. Now I have an overwhelming victory in Christ Jesus. I have an overwhelming victory in Christ Jesus. No matter what we do, no matter what happens, we are all winners through Christ Jesus. So when we accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, we're going to win. We can't win against sin on ourselves. We can't win against fear by ourselves. We can't win against doubt by ourselves. We can't win against worry about ourselves, but we can win through our helmet of salvation. So when fear, when worry, when all of these things keep coming in, right? My salvation already took on this. So I'm going to put on the whole armor of God and I'm going to stand in the truth of my salvation of who I am in Christ Jesus. Because the word says neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries tomorrow, not even the powers of hell can separate me from God's love. It's only through Christ Jesus. So take the stance in your salvation that the blood is at work and it does not matter. I am nothing can separate me from the love of God. And when the enemy starts talking death to you, you speak the life. I am alive in Christ Jesus. I will alive in Christ Jesus. Nothing separates me from God's love. And if you've been sinning or in sin, go on and repent. Don't let the enemy loves to shut your mouth up. He wants you to think that repentance is not enough. You turn your face towards God. You get your face in God's face. That's why God said David was a man after his own heart. God stayed in that. David stayed in God's face. You read Psalms 51 over your life and you call out and you ask God for mercy and you ask God to redeem the time, but be firm in your salvation that nothing can separate you from the love of God and that we serve a strong God. We serve a God mighty in battle. We serve a Redeemer and our Redeemer lives, and you be encouraging that and you take the word in by faith. And when the enemy comes in like a flood, then you lift up the standard, and the standard is the word of God. That's what the standard is. The standard is the word of God. You're winning because of salvation. You're winning because of Jesus. He already paid the price and you got to take it. You got to take it back to the cross. You got to take it back to the cross. You got to take it back. You got to remind yourself, right? That's Isaiah 59:19. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against him. You know what I'm saying? So that's he will lift up a standard, and the word of God is a standard. Yeah, the word of God is a standard. And when you fall off, get into Psalms 51, read, create in me a clean heart. Set your things on things above and not on things of this earth. Remember Psalms 27? I read that the other day. He hides us high above our enemies. That set the course for me. He hides me above my enemies. So if I stay above my enemies, you know how people say, keep your head out the clouds? No, this time I'm going to tell you to keep your heads in the cloud. If I hide myself, if I'm above my enemies, then I'm only going to think of things below, above, and not but things below. I'm going to speak to the heavens, thy kingdom come. If there ain't no plague, no sickness, no disease, no fever, no poverty, no lack in heaven, then it don't belong in your life. Right? It done below. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Our earthly lives have to line up with heaven. So we thank you, God. We thank you, God, for your word.
Please stay tuned for this week's announcements. Join us this week. We have the devotional Tuesday through Friday at 6 a.m. Lady Bible study Tuesday at 7 p.m., but it is virtual only. And then join us for the Saturday morning prayer call at 7 a.m.
LaKisha M. Johnson, also known as LMJ, is an evangelist, teacher, entrepreneur, mentor, author, trainer, and community advocate. She is the founder of LMJ Ministries and CEO of LMJ Inc., a printing, publishing, and consulting firm. LaKisha self-published her first book in April 2019, entitled The Launch, a book for anyone who wants to start anything. She is the host of Coffee and Conversations, a digital interactive daily devotional on 11 podcast outlets, including Apple Podcast, Google Podcast, Facebook Live, YouTube, and Instagram. She's been heard in over 40 countries. She is the creator and host for Pillow Talk, an exclusive event created by women, especially for women. LaKisha is mission-minded. She is focused on serving God by serving others. If you had to describe her in one word, it would be tenacious. LaKisha believes in order to impact our communities and make significant impact, a person should be actively engaged in service and or entrepreneurship and love. LaKisha's famous quote is, go be loved today.
Do me a favor, go
ladies
be loved
and gentlemen, LaKisha M. Johnson.